This is Travis Zimmerman of Speak My Word Ministries. The Daily Pulse today is about idols, and I've talked on idols a number of times over the past 2 years, and it is an important reminder about idols. So as I'm reading through the Bible this year, I come across this passage and I realize, oh my goodness, Lord, I just need to share this one. This is out of Psalm chapter 135, verses 15 through 18. The idols of the nations are silver and gold, made by the hands of men. They have mouths, but cannot speak, eyes, but cannot see. They have ears, but cannot hear, nor is there breath in their mouths. Those who make them will be like them, and so will all who trust in them. And that's Psalm chapter 135, verses 15 to 18. As the psalmist says here, these idols are worthless. These idols have no life in them, nor can they give life. And as a chilling reminder here, those who make them will be like them, and so will all who trust in idols. Nothing. Gone. And that's a reminder for us. You know, even us, we who believe in Jesus Christ, we have to be careful of idols in our own lives. And idols can be, you know, we won't make graven images, likely, or we won't be bowing down and worshiping cows. But what do we do with our free time? What do we do with this? You know, what is taking our eye off the ball from God? Is it our pursuits at work? Is it our, you know, our pleasures, you know, our motorboats, our fast cars, our hobbies? Even our family can become an idol. God has to be and demands to be number one in our lives. And when we don't make Him number one, there's problems. And I'll confess, I don't make God a lot of times number one. And that's to my shame and to my sin. In this specific passage, obviously we can see that God's specifically, you know, talking to those who are making physical idols. But the same caution can be applied, just stepping a little away from that, that we are not to have other things turn our eyes from Jesus, because He is our King, and we are to keep our eye on the ball, keep our eye on Jesus. In Your name, Father, amen.